distinguished guests, Dr. Charles Elaki, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I am honored to address the third meeting of the International Committee on Global Navigation Satellite Systems on behalf of the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs. I am particularly pleased to be doing it for the first time as director of the office. Ladies and gentlemen, the programs of the office are in large part mandated by the United Nations Committee on the Peaceful Uses of Outer Space, also known as COPUS. COPUS has been very effective in building consensus and agreements on its programs through three United Nations International Conferences on the Exploration and Peaceful Uses of Outer Space, which we also call UNISPACE. The first UNISPACE conference was held in 1968. It was conceived as a forum for exchanging information on a global scale. It recommended that a United Nations program on space applications be established to disseminate the practical benefits of space applications and the opportunities available through international cooperation, focusing on the needs of developing countries. The program was duly established in 1971, and one of the priority thematic areas of the program is GNSS and its utilization. The second UNISPACE conference was held in 1982. Its purpose was to exchange information and experience on recent developments in space science and technology, and to set in motion new ways of strengthening United Nations activities related to outer space. Among other things, UNISPACE 82 recommended the expansion of the program on space applications and a broadening of its mandate. This resulted in the establishment of the UN-affiliated Regional Centers for Space Science and Technology Education in India, Nigeria, Morocco, and Brazil, Mexico. All these centers are fully operational and are playing a very effective role at the regional level. Due to this, deliberations of the ICG recently recommended to utilize these UN-affiliated regional centers as ICG information centers. The third UNISPACE conference was held in 1999. Its purpose was to increase the benefits of space science and technology for humanity. The Vienna Declaration, emanating from UNISPACE 3, put forth 33 recommendations. Now, a unique mechanism formulated for the implementation of these recommendations was the formation of action teams, as referred to by Ken. These action teams were led by member states. The work carried out by the particular action team on GNSS, as you know, led to the establishment of ICG. We are deeply honored that the ICG also took the decision to appoint the Office for Outer Space Affairs as its executive secretariat. As can be seen in this third meeting of the ICG, the work of ICG is growing rapidly in line with the anticipation that GNSS applications will grow explosively in the coming years. Allow me to also inform you that the office coordinates activities related to space carried out by agencies within the United Nations system. Some of the items considered by the interagency meeting on outer space include space-related outcomes of the World Summit on Sustainable Development, the World Summit for the Information Society, and the United Nations participation in the Group on Earth Observations, as well as the Committee on Earth Observation Satellites. It is timely, then, that in this regard, the 2009 interagency meeting will focus on GNSS and the work of ICG. Ladies and gentlemen, GNSS has been a major focus of the office since 2001, since the first of its workshop series that took place in Kuala Lumpur. Since then, the office allocates part of its regular budget to this thematic area in the form of workshops and training courses. Beginning 2009, the office has a strategic plan to systematically support several ICG-related activities through fellowships and grants. The human resource of the office dedicated to the ICG work, however, remains limited. Through a process of reprioritization and redeployment, one staff member is now fully dedicated to GNSS and ICG, and another spends half his time. As the work of ICG escalates, more human resource needs to be allocated. And the office continues to have to look into innovative ways of incorporating the work within its existing resources. It is in this regard that I would like to appeal to active members of the ICG to consider the possibility of allocating necessary human resource to the ICG work of the Executive Secretariat work. One mechanism that is used regularly by member states to enhance the level of human resource is the secondment of associate experts to the office. I would be extremely pleased to discuss this further with any interested member states. Ladies and gentlemen, let me now take the opportunity to express the deepest appreciation of the office, the government of the United States, in particular to the Jet Propulsion Laboratory for hosting this third ICG meeting. I hope that in the next few days, you will be able to successfully deliberate on how the work of ICG will be brought to the fore in the coming years. The Office for Outer Space Affairs that acts as the Executive Secretariat of ICG is looking forward to cooperate with the membership of ICG in the future for the benefit of all member states of the United Nations. Thank you for your attention.
Well, thank you, Maslan. Again, we greatly appreciate the support that you and the office have provided to us in the past and look forward to greater support in the future.